And moving on to immigration matters, a police change announced or policy change announced earlier this month by U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services or USCIS puts more immigrants at risk for deportation. USCIS handles immigration benefits like certain work visas, student visas, green cards, and naturalization ceremonies, and has some deportation powers, specifically through issuing a notice to appear or NTA, a document that initiates removal proceedings and orders immigrants to appear before a judge. A memo made public earlier this month now grants the agency the ability to issue an NTA in a wider range of circumstances, including instances when an immigrant is found to have a history of criminal offense or fraud. NCIS can also issue an NTA if an immigrant's application is denied or if they are found to be unlawfully present in the United States. Previously, if their application for a benefit was denied, immigrants would have the chance to appeal the decision, reapply, or leave the country voluntarily if they fall out of status. USCIS says that the change would help align the agency's practices with the Department of Homeland Security's enforcement priorities.
Pinoy Panawagan is brought to you by Tansinko Law Offices.
And for some experts insight into this matter, we're joined by Pinoy Panawagan Legal Counsel, Attorney Lou Tansinko. Thank you for joining us here, Attorney Lou.
My pleasure to be here, Joe.
Attorney Lou, whatever happened to the policy prioritizing those with criminal history? Now, according to the news that I just read earlier, it looks like, you know, people who've been denied of their application are now would possibly be given that NTA notice to appear, which is, you know, a signal that they would be deported.
Yes, I think we have to give it perspective, Jill. This is occurring right now because last year in 2017, there were executive orders. One is on enforcement of the exterior or the border. That's why they are actually tightening the border. And the other one is executive order on the interior enforcement. And it's supposed to be ICE doing it. Now they're doing it through the USCIS. Now your question is, what if it's denied? Will they be presumed to be in removal proceedings? More likely than not, because of this new NTA guidance, if there is reason to show or if there is now finding of unlawful presence as a result of the denial, they will find themselves in removal proceedings. So the priorities that you mentioned before, they have now been expanded. Mm-hmm. So, which is not too good.
But the big problem here also is that, you know, we've also been reporting we lack judges to hear this immigration cases and deportation proceedings. Yeah. So what happens now? What's the impact on this?
That's the problem now, Jill. If they will start putting people in removal proceedings, and there are only more than 300 judges right now, and 700,000 pending cases, you expect more backlog in the system, and it will take a longer time for these cases to be resolved.
But in the meantime, where will these people go, those who have been denied?
Well, those who have been denied, if they are actually staying here, they have to face their removal proceedings cases. If they decide to leave, there's going to be a removal order that will be issued to them. So there are different case scenarios. They can probably voluntarily depart, but that means certain circumstances that might prevent them from coming back
in the future. I'm sure this is what our Kababayans watching us right now want to know. What should they do in case they are, you know, potentially be facing this kind of scenario when they apply and then they get denied? What would you advise them to do to prepare for it?
In view of this new NTA guidance, those who are applying for naturalization, adjustment of status, those doing change of status, I would advise them to have a serious discussion with their legal counsel and ask whether they actually meet the requirements to get an approval or what are the chances of approval. Or second, if they are put in removal proceedings, they have to ask the lawyer, will there be a chance to stay if this case is going to be presented before the court? Mm-hmm. And lastly, they might want to also think and weigh whether or not it's worth filing for those applications or petitions.
All right.
So exercise due diligence.
All right. Thank you very much for giving us your insights, Attorney Lou Tansinko.
My pleasure. You.
And if you need advice for any legal problems, send your questions to pinoypanawagan@tansinko.com or call the hotline 1-800-999-9096. And